Hi everybody and welcome to Usitility. Well, we're on the way to see how to run Infinity Kingdom on PC. Here you're able to watch it on screen. It takes almost no time to efficiently download and set up Infinity Kingdom and play this game on our Windows PC using our gamer keyboard if we want to, mouse and big screen. So it's time to have fun, let's get to it. Before anything else mates, the first thing to do is to launch our favorite web browser. We selected the one we prefer. Let's continue, going to this URL I'm highlighting in green color. There you are seeing it on the screen of the PC. You don't need to type it, because I provided a clickable link in the description of this video and as well in the first main comment. We arrived there on the website of Usitility, at which we get an in-depth outline on how to download Infinity Kingdom on PC. We browse down a little bit and just click on the Download Game on PC button. After we click on this link, we reach the website of BlueStacks. No panic, it is simply the Android emulator that we will run to play Infinity Kingdom on PC. It is now obvious that we have a number of pros of preferring that emulator. Then, we are ready to start downloading the Infinity Kingdom by clicking on this button Play on BlueStacks that I have marked in green. We then click on it. Of course, the download takes no time at all. Here it is, here is located the download. It's an executable file. What we have to do is to run the installer, so we click on the file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to make modifications to the computer. We have clicked yes. I reduce the internet browser to find the installer better. The installation software is very simple. It contains two possibilities, install, and setup path. I am going to describe what setup path does indeed. We merely click on it. Therefore we note that we end up with here the path where your emulator can be set up. If we need to modify this directory we must click on the Browse button, and we opt for another folder and set up the emulator where we wish. I will leave it by default. I simply click on Back. And therefore I simply click Install. Great. The setup begins and it's going to go forward together with the download of those megabytes that are displayed on the screen. Once you save it on your machine, it is likely to be slightly more or less megabytes. The download rate will go faster or slower, subject to your type of connection and depending on the speed of the emulator web servers. Immediately they are working quite fast. The download is completed, and so right now it continues with the setup step. The installation will need more or less time depending on the power of your PC. The more powerful it's actually, the faster the software setup time and vice versa. If we put together the download and software installation phase it can take a very long time, so have patience. It has already ended for me. At this point, the emulator happens to be started immediately. As you will notice, down here, there's a progress bar that will fill up so when it actually reaches the finish, the emulator will be launched for the first time. The reality is the emulator was already started, here for the very first time. Before we continue on, as you can see now, it has made two app icons here on the PC desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks software icon is the one we are interested in. Anytime we would like to launch Infinity Kingdom on the PC, we twice click this particular icon and consequently use the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance app icon is not related to multiplayer or even anything like this. The fact is, it is an icon that we will probably never utilize. We should perform the following step, that is a must-have, and that's to begin browsing the Google Play Store. As you will notice the Google Play is started. Right here we must log on. At present as soon as we're there, we must absolutely accomplish the following step which is mandatory. So we click on, sign in. At this point it shows, checking info. It could in some cases get stopped at, checking info, and this doesn't progress. In that case, you could attempt to log in after a number of hours and it'll most certainly be resolved. At this point we're going to insert our email and password. The email needs to be a Gmail email address and its corresponding password. For example, you can use the same email you're using currently in your YouTube account. Thus I will insert my data and I'll revisit as soon as I have done it. That's all, details typed in. And here is Google welcoming us and presenting us the terms of service. We can accept them by clicking on, I agree. After that, it makes it possible to save to the Google Cloud. You could keep it checked and it'll produce a backup of the data on this device to Google Drive. I will not check it, you do what you want. We simply click on accept. The Google Play Store is launched automatically and immediately. To set up the app game, we must visit the emulator desktop by clicking this icon marked green colored. Currently that we are watching the desktop of this Android emulator, we can see that we now have right here the install video game button. We just click on the button. At this point we have got the game app. Let's quickly then click there on the install option that I am highlighting now in green. This will commence the software installation. At present it is going to install the video game, it might take a while or it may be very fast. It again all is dependent upon on our own internet connection. It's just finished installing. Back to the emulator desktop by pressing this particular button I'm presenting in green, to be able to run Infinity Kingdom for the first time. Shall we simply click on that My Games option just above? I am now on the emulator desktop, and therefore we're on the way to simply click on that brand new Infinity Kingdom icon that has been created. That video game is started for the first time. Here we have it. I'm able to press anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I am going to discuss the volume level of this emulator. This is here. We have got the icon of higher volume and also the icon of lower volume. This way we will not depend on the Windows volume to increase or decrease the audio of your emulator. As well as to take pleasure in the experience to the maximum, we could activate the big screen, for which we have two choices. That is actually the first one, we just click on that icon that I am pointing out in green. Then the monitor is maximized, offering one border on top, one at the right and one at the bottom. Supposing that we would like to run the video game using all the screen, we click on this particular app icon. And therefore we would likely at present be experiencing the gameplay in full screen setting. To get out of the full screen mode, press the F11 key. And we might now end up being in standard computer screen mode. From now, I am choosing to demonstrate you the computer keyboard mapping and that is actually extremely exciting. This way we will be able to use the game application a lot more effortlessly. The first point is to mouse click this computer keyboard icon. And right now there you will be able to get the required setups. I am about to keep the standard configuration, but if you want to change it, you may very well do so without having problem. As you can notice, the emulator is entirely in our own language. Occasionally it occurs that the emulator is started in the incorrect language, for example, in Chinese. So to place it in the proper language we click here to the cogwheel. So there inside of additional configuration settings, we simply click on the language drop down. We may opt for the language we want, English, Chinese, etc. Once the language is determined, we could save, the emulator will restart, and also the Android game, the next time we launch it, will as well be in the selected language. At this time, there's another information that we will need to take into consideration, and it is that we will receive an email saying that a new device has been connected to our Google account. It will likely check with us if we're the ones who have associated with that electronic device. Indeed, we should not get worried, considering that the emulator is emulating an Android smartphone or tablet. And then to find which smartphone or tablet is being emulated, we visit here, to the cogwheel and we simply click on it. So we go here to the model choice. And right here we learn that the emulator is acting as a Samsung mobile phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it folks, so much for that training. I hope that you liked it, particularly that you found it useful. If so, give it a good thumb up, subscribe, and any comments, issues or ideas, leave them in the comment box down below. You can even comment things on my Twitch channel, I do live streams on occasion, you have it below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Simply click on any of those videos which are usually appearing on the suggestion of videos to watch and let's have fun again in the upcoming videos. Bye.